gotta shut the cell off, cause the iPhone don't got a jet mode. Bad be pesto. If you wanna come, let's go. We ain't going nowhere special.
Wrist man, check the wrist man, got him hot. Ay. Man can't ball like this man, Lord. Pass the pig scan when he stretch a distance. I'm talking a few 100,000 yards, you just on your 5th grand. Run it up, 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 count it up. Ay, 100s and 50s and 20s, no fives and no singles, don't count on them. Ay, she wanted like me, cause I like she can't count on him. She tried to be nosy and hit on my ex, she like, girl, you can count on him.
Hey, hey, we need more, tell him we need more. Putting numbers on the board, like I'm keeping score. Ay, 16 cars in my front yard. Ay, 30 on my wrist, bullet points of car. Big numbers, big numbers. 100 minute bag, that's a big number. Big numbers, big numbers. Whole team counted, that's a big number. Big numbers, big numbers. 100 minute bag, that's a big number.
Chains, I'm about to make a play. Move the chains, tell them get about the way. Move the chains, I'm about to win the game. Move the chains, baby, tell them move the chains. I score up in the end zone, do my dance all on a hater. A mover and a shaker, you a novice, I'm a player. I'm from DC, but I'm running through and sacking like a raider. Two chains on my neck, one for now and one for later. And we don't play fair, baby, we play for keeps. You can pass me up, this is not a bye week. I'm looking for a trophy competition, looking steep. And I'm training, I've been focused, I've been bombing from the deep. I'm like, move the chains, I'm about to make a play. Championships, all my records go hard, it's a champion hit. I've been working for this moment like I've been in the gym. Jumping all over hurdles, I'm evading the pit. Hit the hit with anybody, take them, I can shake them. I invite them to the fire, then I bake them, I'ma break them. I'm a Hall of Fame legend, they should go and hang my jersey. Made to put in work, I don't think they really heard me lie. Move the chains, I'm about to make a play.
The coach take the Lincoln Tunnel through Weehawken, through Secaucus, across the Hackensack River, and you'll arrive, as we have, at MetLife Stadium at East Rutherford, New Jersey. Nothing like the fanfare of introductions to an NFL game, and that was in evidence a moment ago. Fireworks, pyrotechnics, you name it, this crowd is ready as their guys get set to match up between the New England Patriots and the New York Jets. There, a big loss on their first play from scrimmage. It's second down. Got to give some credit there defensively. They snuffed out that screen early on first down.
Really read it well, didn't they? Because they didn't bring the pressure that they expected. They covered all the passing lanes. So once you see it break down as the passer, I think in this situation, you're throwing it at the feet of your back to make sure no one picks it off, or you throw it away, throw it over the sideline. Don't try and freelance and try and make a bigger play. There's really no one else running a pattern that should be open.
Three and out, a real danger here on their opening drive as they come up on a third and 12. Darnold off the play fake to Bell. Under pressure now, Darnold, and he goes down. D Ford, what a season he continues to have. His 15th sack of the campaign. Here's the Jets punter now. He'll kick it away after a three and out on the opening drive of the game. Taken from just outside the 30. Still going. Now he lost the football. And it's scooped up by the Jets.
I remember sitting in special teams meetings, and at some point during the meeting, the coach would always say, you better treat this one just like you're playing offense or defense. It's a big part of the game. And we just saw evidence of why right there with that fumble.
Yeah, fumble on the punt, and after it was turning up to be a pretty decent return.
Yeah, a really nice return. They were going to be set up okay, and the offense would feel good running onto the field. And now the defense has to try it out there and try and slow them down.
Ready, ready. 90, Wolf. 53.
They'll run for the first time with Sony Michel. And he'll go down right on the edge of the red zone following a pickup of about 7 or 8. He was solid last week, over 100 yards in their victory on the ground. They want to get that going again.
Absolutely. What they also understand is that from week to week, it's not necessarily the same, but they want it to be, right? What they saw last week on the ground, they got...
Well, the ball is out. Michel lost it.
Wow. That ball is not free. But a teammate comes along and scoops it up. Almost like, it's almost like baseball. Guys at bat, people are on base in scoring position. One guy doesn't get them home. The next guy comes through and picks him up.
And avoids the turnover.
Ready?
Back-to-back good plays. Have them on the move on first down. On first and 10, it's Stidham. Nowhere to escape, and he goes down. DeForest Buckner able to record his 5th sack of the season. Partner, we had their game last week where they had 6 sacks, so a little bit more momentum here again in the first quarter.
And last week it appeared that they were coming out of sprinter's blocks, chasing the quarterback. So how do they continue that? How do they keep making it happen? Different looks, different disguises, different angles that they chase him.
They were so disruptive last week. We'll see what the trend is here as we go forward. 5 yards that time on the completion, and now it's third and goal.
Defensively here, you're facing a top 5 team in terms of points scored in the NFL. So when they're that high-powered, you've got to find a way to hold them under 20, because to me, that's the magic number. 20 points scored, give yourself your best chance to win.
So if they're up around 24, 28, 30, they could be in some trouble.
And I think so, because then you turn it into a shootout, and that means your offense has to keep pace.
Yeah, yeah. Check, check. Lucky. Whip. Go. Snap.
On third and goal, Stidham. And he's in. Touchdown, Patriots. James White, his 5th touchdown now on the year, as his guys are able to strike first here in this opening quarter. Point after, right down the middle. And that makes the score 7-0. The kickoff team on the field now as they will send this one away. This one fielded at the 5. They'll bring it back to just about the 25. Call it the 24-yard line. The New York offense taking over for their next possession. And Charles, if the season ended today, and it's not going to, we still have December left.
More football.
Early in November. But they would be a wild card team. And that's great. They'd be in the playoffs, but you know they're trying to bump up to be one of those division leaders.
That guarantees you at least one home game in the playoffs, and that's what you're really seeking. But there also isn't much margin for error for this team, right? Because right where they're sitting, a 2-game losing streak can have them out of the playoffs, so they've got to make sure they continue to keep the momentum going.
Absolutely. There's some sharks smelling blood in the water behind them. An incomplete pass on that last play, and that means they'll need to come up with something here on third down. Out of the shotgun, here's Darnold. Nowhere to escape, and he goes down. D. Ford, he continues to wreak havoc in the offensive backfield. Sack number 16 on the year. Here's the Jets punter now. As the drive goes backwards, so he's on to punt it away. Fielded at the 20. Give him 11 yards that time on the return. And the Patriots take over. The Pats at the line, ready to go. And it's only November, but the playoffs, we know how it works. They'll be here before you know it. If it ended today, they would be the number one seed.
And that's a great spot to be in, but I love the phrase, if it ended today.
Into a double team, and it's intercepted. Snags it for the pick, and he's able to get it back to the 41-yard line. CD, I know it's just his second year in the league as a quarterback, but that's going to be one when he flips on the tape. He's like, I shouldn't have thrown that ball.
No doubt about it, and his coaching staff will be emphatic about he shouldn't have thrown that ball. But remember, second year, as you noted, on the job training, so he's got to take this feedback that he's getting, negative or otherwise, and turn it into positives moving forward.
To throw on second and six. Darnold. Into double coverage and it's intercepted. Devin McCourty picks it off. Thought he had the pick. Flag comes in for PI, so cancel it out.
Interference. Oh, a killer for them. Thought they had a nice play. Instead, they'll be marching off yardage against them.
Check 52.
22 Jet Bomber. 22 Jet Bomber.
Safety's creeping.
And they'll keep it on the ground with Bell. And he'll get this one down to about the 10-yard line. Just a yard on the pickup there, and it'll bring up a second and nine. This defense against the run, by the way, they're not top five, but they are top 10.
So what's your philosophy here? Do you try and run the ball against a team that's pretty good against the run? What if you're a pretty good running team? If so, you might want to go ahead and run it anyway, because that's your strength.
And he'll be brought down this time at the 5-yard line. 6 yards is the pickup, and that'll lead to a third down. They come up with one running back. That's Bell. And they'll give it to him here. And this is going to result in losing yardage. They're driven back to the 8-yard line. He loses four, and it brings up fourth. Plays like we just saw there, that's why they're up right now. And the defense, they're doing their job.
Yeah, it starts with the guys up front. So when you talk with GMs who are putting together a team, a lot of them say, we're going to build from the inside out, because if you control the line of scrimmage, you control the rest of the ball game. And that's what we're seeing here. They're actually playing in the offense's backfield, not necessarily just playing at the line of scrimmage.
And they will not get a chance to return this one, as it's through the end zone for a touchback. The Pats at the line, ready to go. A tale of two extremes already in this game. A touchdown pass on their opening drive, followed by an interception last time out.
Now, it sounds like things balance out, right? What's that mythological thing that we do? If you have a candy bar, have a diet soda with it, it balances it out. And we know that's not really true, right? Because the interception, that sting lingers a little bit longer. Got to come out now and put together some nice plays.
Try to get one more in here before the quarter breaks. After one, 7-3 the score on EA Sports.
15-1.
Now a first down carry. It's Michelle. And he'll get this one down near the 20-yard line, just shy of the 20. That one, 28 yards on the ground.
50, plant.
On first down, Stidham. Into a double team, and it's intercepted. Picked off down near the five.
So that's back-to-back drives where they've thrown an interception. Ordinarily, we look at the offense and say, what's going on with your scheme? Maybe we should look at the defense and just give them a whole lot of credit. They've got them frustrated right now.
They go play action here on first down. And this will be incomplete. Physical play on the football there, and it's second down.
And it is true. You can draft the fastest. You can draft the most athletic guys. But if they don't know the art of positioning, sometimes it's all for naught. In this case, in the right spot, helped force the incompletion.
Yeah, but had his hands on it for a second. Would have been a tough catch, though. Falls incomplete. After the incomplete pass here now is second and 10. Darnold. That's complete. It's Bell. And they'll bring him down right around the 13. They'll give him 8 on the play, and that'll lead here to a third down. Second down pass play got him 8 yards. Now they've got a third and a couple remaining. A shotgun snap for Darnold. He's going to look deep for Perriman. Oh, this is taken in. It's complete. And he'll go out near midfield at the 49. What a play that turns out to be. 36 yards. From the shotgun, it's a give to Bell. And he'll take it across the 50 and into New England territory. It's a 6-yard pickup, but it gets him to 2nd and 4.
Even though they gave up more than they wanted to on that play, it actually illustrates how well they bottled him up throughout the game, because that was his longest run of this contest.
Former Purdue Boilermaker, Raheem Mostert. And he'll go down here at the 35-yard line. 9 yards to pick up there, and it's a first down.
Tremendous blocking by the interior of the offensive line. They didn't just gash him there. They blasted a gaping hole for him to gallop through. I think if he comes back to the huddle, he better be giving them a whole lot of credit and thanking them for that much space to rumble.
Now Mostert. He's got a first down and much more inside the 20. And he'll go out of bounds inside the 15-yard line. That good for 22 and a first down.
This has been a good drive so far, and it's been the running game for the most part that's powered them down there. Another nice burst there, picking up a first down. Now it's first and 10, as you said, in the red zone.
This offense finding its legs now. Here's another first and 10.
A 6-6, pull it high.
SOS, SOS, SOS.
Under 10, under 10, 10. Check 13, check 13. Tighten up, tighten up.
Young lady.
Why, get wide. 6 guy, check 6 guy. Back up.
This is Bell. Trying to bounce it outside, but he's only able to get it back to the line of scrimmage.
Switch it.
No gain on the play there, second down.
No gain on the play. Brings up second and 10.
That's it, baby.
So after the run for no gain, here's second and 10. And they'll try the air now with Darnold. Caught here by Bell. A minimal gain there on the 8th play of the drive.
Everyone's got to be able to catch the football. Doesn't matter what position you play, but if you're on offense, be aware, ball may come your way.
The Jets on 3rd down. They've only converted once in 4 tries. This is 3rd and 7. Darnold from the gun. His pass caught with the 4. And he won't have the touchdown, but he will have the first down as he's tackled at the 2. They're able to convert on 3rd down, and that sets up a 1st and goal.
They can't hang with us. Bang, 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 bang.
Young lady.
Alert 3, alert 3, alert 3.
Showing it, showing it.
They'll try and run for it on 1st and goal. And they'll be driven back here, losing yardage to the 9. He lost 6 there on the 1st down play.
The short field shrinks even more with the type of bodies they brought in on that play. Those extra tight ends, they weren't able to secure their blocks, and that one ended up going backwards.
50. Check 50.
On second and goal, they'll give it to him again. And he will maneuver his way down to about the 7. Only a yard there, and that'll bring us to third and goal. Two minutes to play in this first half. 7-3, our score. And we remind you, coming up at the half, we'll join who, Charles?
The coach.
The coach, Jonathan Coachman, standing by in Orlando. He'll have stats and scores from games in progress, as well as scores from earlier today.
The coach.
Sorry, we get. And he's going to take it in for a Jets touchdown. Le'Veon Bell with his 16th touchdown of the year. And the Jets have taken the lead. Getting your back involved, what's the importance there in the passing game?
Well, oftentimes you can create mismatches because who's going to cover him? And you get him into space, which is where he likes to operate with the ball in his hands. Oftentimes makes people miss, gets that run after the catch, and off he goes.
And into the end zone. And a good effort on the return there. Gets him across the 30 to the 33-yard line.
Ready, break.
The Pats at the line, ready to go. And two interceptions already here in this first half. That's got to affect him a little bit, right? He's got to be thinking about it.
He's got to be thinking about it, but most of the good ones, they find a way to put it aside. They're not happy about it by any stretch of the imagination. They find a way to put it aside and continue to play their game.
Can he put it aside? Let's find out. Second and 10 from the 33-yard line. Second and 10 now, Stidham. It's complete. James White. And he'll be out of bounds after getting this one across the 40. Give him 9 on the play, and that'll make it 3rd and 1. Looked like a pretty good, safe play right there. No, he's had trouble with the interceptions in this game there. Hits his guy out in the flat.
Yeah, so many times we hear quarterbacks and offensive coordinators talk about in your progressions, you're either throwing the touchdown or you're throwing the check down. But earlier in the game, it was touchdown or interception. Now he got to the check down, a nice safe throw and a good one.
The Jets are going to use the first of their timeouts as they'll head to the sideline. And look at this, it's a fake. Shreds the tackle. It'll be a 2-yard gain. It's such a risky play there to fake it. You're either the hero or the goat. Here they're going to be the goat.
Unfortunate, too, because you know they thought they had something there. They don't call it just a call. They don't just say, oh, what the heck, let's go ahead and fake it here. They feel like they've got something on. They've got the defense in the right spot. Just unsuccessful in that opportunity.
Now a first down carry by Bell. And he'll take this one down to about the 40. Credit him with a 1-yard gain there to make it 2nd and 9. Here's 2nd and 9, just a yard on that last run.
Bravo.
Here's Darnold. Looking left side, and he's got a man. It's Bell. Call it a gain of 3, and that's going to lead to a 3rd down.
And we see another pitch and catch there to the running back. This position just continues to evolve. They've become just as critical to the passing attack as a lot of receivers, tight ends, because their ability to make people miss in the open field can really generate big plays for an offense.
Throw complete to Herndon. And he is out of bounds, but not before he's inside the 30. It'll go as a gain of 11 and a Jets first down.
I like how they work the tight end on a nice little under route there. And if you're going to give him that much space, he's not even going to catch the football. He's going to run away from me a little bit, and that's exactly what he just did there, picking up extra yardage.
Darnold now, 9 of 11 passing in this first half. He's got his guys at 1st and 10. He'll try and set up the screen. It's complete. And he'll lose yardage. Brought down at the 32. Now the Jets going to use the 2nd of their 3 timeouts, as the clock will stop with 20 seconds to go in the first half.
Here goes that.
Check 99. Check 99. Trip. We got trip. We got 3.
The red 80. Jim.
Lady.
Shit. On 2nd down, it's Bell. And he'll be brought down inside the 20 at the 19. The Jets going to go ahead and use their final timeout as they'll stop it with 14 seconds to go in this first half. So out comes the field goal team now for the second time here today. From the left hash, it's a 36-yard attempt. Rosas' kick is good. And the lead stretches to six here. It's 13-7. So good work there to get points just before the half as they add on to their lead.
As trite as it sounds, every little bit helps. That's exactly what they're going for. Anytime you get a chance to put points on the board, you take it.
And they didn't leave the other side with much time at all on the clock.
Let's go! Do it! Ready.
The Pats at the line, ready to go. Likely time for just one final play, and then it'll be off to the locker room to talk about how they can erase this deficit.
Yeah, and I think a lot of people look at it and go, well, maybe you take a shot here. Maybe you get some momentum going into the half. What's the flip side of that? You do something crazy, quarterback gets hit, ball comes free, and now you're down an even bigger margin. Go ahead and take this one, go to the locker room, start over.
The last run got a couple. Here's second and eight.
Get off the field. 61, match box, play.
They'll keep it on the ground again here. He'll have a first down past the 40. And he'll take it to the 43-yard line. So we have reached halftime in what's a six-point game at the break. As we'll get you down the coast to Orlando for Jonathan Coachman at REA Sports Halftime Report. Coach! Fielded about a yard deep. And not a bad return here. He gets it out to the 25-yard line. The Pats at the line, ready to go. They're down here, but very much in this game. What's the tonality of a coach's talk when a game is within striking distance like this at intermission?
Typically, what they're doing is emphasizing the things that went well in the first half and wanting more of that. Sure, you've got to go over some of the errors and clean up some things because there's a reason you're down. But overall, I think they want to stay positive, stay up with this team. We're just starting the second half, and we've got the football. Let's go ahead and punch it in, and then we'll take it from there.
See how that recipe works. Call it a gain of four there, so it sets up a big play here, third and a yard.
On any running play that's called, they're always hoping that it's going to break big and go the distance. But when you get a nice game like that, you're able to do so many things anyway. You can come back and run essentially the same play again, continue to move the ball on the ground, or you can decide to throw the ball now because usually you have the defense back on its heels.
The Jets will bring in a nickel set here as they try to stop this third down. Again, it's Michelle. And he's able to get the first before he's taken down at the 36. It's a first down following a gain of three. So from the 36 now, first and 10 on the ground. This is Michelle. He's got a first down and then some at midfield. The 20, 10, and all the way in. Touchdown, New England. Sony Michelle with touchdown number 12 on the year. And now they can recapture the lead if they can make the PAT. Extra point splits the uprights, and that will put them on top here in the third. Out is the kickoff unit as they run up and send this one away. And this will be a touchback as that sails over the end line. The New York offense taking over for their next possession. They trail offense, first time to touch the ball in quarter three, and we'll see what they can do.
And I can't wait to see what they have planned, because some teams script.
Blitz coming, and down he goes. So the opening drive of this third quarter, they're trying to set the tone for the second half.
And without a doubt, they did exactly that. I've known coaches who have said the first 5 minutes of each half are so important to do exactly what you said, which is set the tone. I've also heard coaches talk about the first five plays. Let's go out and be aggressive right off the top. That's exactly what they did.
Well, they're in some hot water now after that sack. It's second and 21. There's Bell. And a short gain across the 15 to the 17-yard line. He'll get three, but it leaves him with a big hole here on third and very long. Third and long, it's Darnold. He rifles one that's intercepted. Picked off at the 36. He's at it again, Charles. He had the pick six last week. Not a pick six here, but an interception.
It's another OSCE, because that's the word we use when we intercept the pass. OSCE tells your team to rally around and block for you. Well, that worked really well last week because he had made it all the way to the end zone. This week he got the OSCE, maybe not a touchdown, but boy, he's playing really well.
On the ground is Michelle, and he'll be stopped after a gain of only a couple down to the 15-yard line.
Watching that play unfold and watching him complete it brought back memories of doing all those pursuit drills to make sure you don't over-pursue and let a guy get a cutback lane on you. He did that very well.
You praised him on tape yesterday for the angles that he takes to the ball. Took a great angle right there. On second down, here's Stidham. Firing quickly here, and that's complete. And he's brought down just outside of the 10 at the 11. 4 yards on the completion, and it sets up a third down. Well, they were handed great starting field position on this drive, but now they face a third and four.
General West! Hey! Wahoo! Get it.
To throw is Stidham. Stidham hit, and he lost it.
On plays like this where the ball comes free, it's often unusual for the team that lost it to get it back, because this is the quarterback. The ball gets away from him. Everyone else is trying to execute what they're supposed to do on offense. They're usually looking in the other direction, downfield, or have moved away from him. In this case, though, a teammate is able to come up with the ball.
They got the interception, but very little movement after. That forces him to settle for three. And it does feel like settling when that happens, doesn't it?
It certainly does, but we got to give a lot of credit where it's due, and that's to the defense, because they ran onto the field. This is what we call sudden change, right? Interception, you've got to go put out the fire. And they did, holding them to a field goal.
The New York offense taking over for their next possession. And following the interception, just any interception, are you a little bit more cautious when you start that next drive, or no, you just throw that out the window?
I think you are. I don't think that there's any way you can run back out there and go, totally didn't affect me. Let's just go ahead and be loose with the football again. You're going to take care of it, but you have to be careful about being too cautious, because now you can't run any offense at all.
Still want to attack. We'll see how they attack them here. They'll go again with Bell. And he's able to take this one up to the 35-yard line. 2 yards, good enough for a first.
But we always talk about good down and distance allowing offenses to expand their playbook. Well, second and two, that means your playbook's wide open. You can run just about anything. But a lot of times, the play caller, he just looks down at his sheet, sees the short yardage runs, and goes to one of those.
This is Mostert. And he's tackled a yard short of the marker. Good gain of 9 on first down.
Despite the blitz, they're still able to pick up a nice solid gain. The disadvantage of blitzing often alters the normal spacing and run fits and leaves creases like they were able to exploit right there.
The last run got 9. That leaves him with 2nd and a yard. Here's Darnold. Here, complete. And he's got another first down as the tackle's going to be made at the Patriots 39. And just a small glimpse there as to why they like this rookie so much.
And that's why they lit up a little bit in our meetings with the coaching staff, didn't
they? When we talked about him, they did.
Yeah, you know, they like his work ethic. You know, this guy's running every route well in the route tree and getting better at it all the time, really honing his game. They expect a pretty good jump out of him as things continue to move on. They tried a quick hitter inside, but that one was swallowed up because what they're hoping, those big defensive linemen will take the bait and move laterally and open up a crease that they can run through. Didn't happen on that play.
Throwing on second and eight, Darnold. Throwing left side here, and it's complete. That catch good for five. It's third down. Darnold on third down. And tight coverage there. It's knocked away, incomplete. The veteran Stephon Gilmore able to break that one up.
Well, this at least is the right idea. I think they've got to get the tight end more involved.
He had just one target in the first half, incomplete. Now incomplete here with the first target of the second half.
Yeah, should not stop them at all from going back to him. They'll find him. Find him.
And this will split the uprights. It's right down the middle. And that'll bring him back within a point. He's got 9 points on field goals now. He's made three of them. That gets him a bit closer, but there's no question they need to start turning some of these threes into sixes.
And for him, it's not his concern, right? He just goes out there when they call on him and goes ahead and puts points up on the board. But the offense has got to get together and figure out what's stalling their drives so they have to keep calling on him.
The Pats at the line, ready to go. And last time they got 3 points, but it was a chip shot field goal. And when you go to the sideline after a chip shot field goal, maybe the offense not too happy.
It's a balancing act, isn't it? Because
and that is intercepted. Or was it? Wait, they'll say no. No interception. He did not keep the feet in bounds, apparently. So that's just going to be an incompletion.
Let's go.
From the 21, it's second and 10. Stidham again here on second and 10. And that's off the mark, incomplete. James White, the man he was looking for out of the backfield. And it'll bring up third down. Big play coming up. Here's third and 10.
I would expect to see some pressure here.
Hey. Check.
The pressure drops off as they'll look to throw. And the throw there going to be incomplete. The Patriots send out their punter as he's on to punt for the first time this afternoon. And this is away. It's a high kick, and he got all of it. This is taken at about the 14. And he's out of bounds, but not before a big pickup that time on what's going to wind up being the final play of the third quarter. Back now here on EA Sports. And we've got a dandy here. A one-point game as we begin the fourth. Now a play fake here on first down. He's going to loft one deep left side here. That's going to be knocked away and incomplete. They were trying to erase that deficit in one play.
They certainly were, but how about the reaction time and the instincts back deep to force the incompletion? We might need to mark this one down. We may look back and say, that was a game-saving play.
On second down, it's Bell, and able to work about 5 yards out of this as he's taken down up near the 47. The Jets on third down, not quite 50%, 4 for 9. This will be third and 5. To throw is Darnold. Herndon's got it complete. 2 yards is all they'll get on the completion. It's fourth down.
One hallmark of good defenses is understanding the game, understanding positioning, and tackling immediately in the secondary after catches. I think we just saw that on display right there.
Got to him before he ever had a chance to think about turning it upfield. The Pats at the line, ready to go. And on the last go-around, they really couldn't get anything going.
They had to punt from deep inside their own territory, which means you're going to lose the field position battle as a general rule.
What they're looking for now is a little more consistency, move the ball at least a few times on offense, get a couple of first downs, and hopefully flip the field.
Yeah, just something to build off of. That's what they're looking for here.
At the 24-yard line.
A good run, got seven on first. Here's second and three. Stidham goes underneath here to White. Give him 2 yards on that play, and that's going to bring up a third down. I think you'd have to say defensively, these guys are doing their job pretty well, right?
Yeah, we talked about them holding them under 20 points, right, on defense, and they've done that. They've held them. The problem is their own offense hasn't answered their challenge, which was to score more.
Yeah, exactly. I remember you saying magic number was right around 20, and the offense has been the issue. You're right. Stidham. Got his man. That's Harry. 14 yards is the pickup there, and a New England first down. This quarterback now perfect since the second half started. 7 of 7. It's first and 10. A first down run. Good for about 3. Second and 7 coming up. Tackled by Jordan Willis. Well, with the fumble he had earlier, we know how key keeping the football is here. That fumble earlier, probably at the forefront of his mind. Just hold on to this thing.
It's also at the forefront of the mind of the guys who are trying to get the ball from him. And since they've seen him drop it on the ground.
And a big loss here as he's taken down.
Sometimes I watch games and wonder why they use play fakes on certain passing situations, because it's not going to fool anyone. I don't know if that was the case here, but the end result was the same. No one fooled. The quarterback was hit.
They go play action now. Stidham. Open man completes it to Smith-Schuster. And he'll get up to the 43-yard line. It'll be a pickup of 16, but they'll remain short of the marker, and it's fourth down.
Look at me, zipper! Hey, Foxtrot, Foxtrot!
I'll go! 53, Mike. Let's go, D! It's gonna be a long day, offense! It's gonna be a long day!
And they're gonna take it all the way down and just take the delay. And that'll be accepted, of course, and that moves him back 5. The Patriots send out their punter as he'll kick it away for the second time. And now a high kick here as they'll try to cover this one. Just a 25-yard punt. Not what he was hoping for by any stretch. And the Jets will take over first and 10. We saw a number of good games earlier today. This one might top all of those. It's been a dandy as we come up on first and 10. They'll start out on the ground with Bell. And he went backwards. He'll be down at the 30. That's going to wind up a loss of a full 3 yards on first down.
He has elite instincts from his linebacker spot. He's able to diagnose the run and flies in like a missile to stop that one behind the line of scrimmage.
Again, it's Bell. A good pickup there, 13 yards as they get closer for third down. So from second and long, now we go to third and very manageable.
Yeah, they love that phrase, don't they? Because as an offensive coordinator, you can keep people a little bit off balance and guessing because you don't have to throw it. You can come back with a strong run game if you want to. And if you're in four down territory, that really opens things up for you.
So it's Jets football as we get you reset here. And let's see what they've come up with offensively after having time to talk it over.
He's crashing. He's checking crack.
Check. 80.
Check hot route.
Protein spill.
Under crunch. Under crunch.
Check four. Check four.
Watch twist.
And 80. I got it.
They'll try and run for it with Bell. And he's got the first down as he's up to the 45-yard line. Officially a gain of just a yard there, but they do convert on third and inches.
Get that ball, D. Let's get that ball.
Watch the safety green. Check safety, check safety.
Mostert. And this one's going to go the wrong way, losing yardage back at the 42. A loss of a full 3 yards, and now it's second down.
Hey, left 3.
Watch out, watch out, watch out, watch out.
They'll look to throw. Throwing left side, it's complete. And he's got another first down as the tackle's going to be made at the Patriots 43. Clock's under a minute. Still plenty of time, partner. They have all 3 timeouts.
That means they have plenty of options in their play calling and where they target on the field. They can throw it downfield, maybe even in the middle, and use their timeouts.
The Jets are going to use the first of their timeouts as they'll stop it with just over 40 seconds to go in the game. Darnold off the play fake to Bell. And, oh, a crusher there as it's intercepted. Picked up by J.C. Jackson.
And that one, oh, it's going to hurt big time. You're in the 2-minute drill trying to get your guys down the field, and it's looking like they're going to come up just short, as this is definitely not his best throw. And it'll wind up being intercepted.
The Pats at the line, ready to go. And still 2 timeouts defensively, but even if they choose to use those, 3 kneel downs should be enough to get out of here with a victory.
And that's exactly what's being stated into the head coach's headset. Oftentimes they have a guy upstairs who monitors this at the end of the game. Little clock management 101.
The run got 4. Now they deal with a 2nd and 6.
Watch the ship. Watch the ship. Watch the ship. Watch the ship.
Yo, yo, yo. Go. Go.
Yeah, they're going to try to eat some clock with Michelle. And they nearly get this all the way to midfield. Mark him down at the 49. So this will wind up a victory for the New England Patriots. And they were spurred on by a strong performance in that 4th quarter as they held their opponents off the scoreboard.
Everyone wants to pitch a shutout for the entire game, but when you throw one in the 4th quarter, that tells everyone that you're getting stronger. And dominance is starting to take over, right? The way that you close, the way that you finish, that gets preached to you from the time you're playing Little League football all the way up through.